Jai Gurudev. So in 1984, when Guruji was 6 years old, he remembers, I made fires in the courtyard of our house or in the garden. It was my yagna, my fire ceremony. I sang whatever came to my mind, mantras made up from scratch. I danced all around the fire and finally I sat down in it. And for this, my mother used to beat me up. At the bottom of a mango tree, my father built a small temple for us out of wood with a corrugated sheet roof. With the neighbor kids, we like to dance. Every day, we also used to do a yagna with wood and ghee. We were between 5 and 7 years old. Nobody had said to us how to make it. We sang mantras, we danced around the fire, we put ghee also inside. And then our neighbor told us not to build fires everywhere. So he built a little hut with a corrugated iron roof. And my friends and I would make our yagnas for hours, throwing whatever we could find into the fire, shouting our mystical formulas and chanting our mantras. Whenever we had free times, we would go to our hut. Sometimes the flames were as high as a roof, but the hut never burned down. God must have been looking forward to our ceremony every day to hear us shouting, Swaha, Swaha, Swaha. This is how Guruji remembered this time. One day Guruji went to the river to catch some fishes, to bring them home. The technique of fishing is about to catch the fish and not to kill it, but to catch the fish without hurting him, to put them in his aquarium at home. Once, I went with Guruji to this fishing adventure to the river. There was so much mosquitoes. They bit me so much that I fell asleep in the car when we came back. And then I could only fall on my bed during 2 hours. So the technique works like this. You take a plastic bottle that you cut in the middle and you reverse the top part. Then you put a piece of bread inside the bottle so the fish come inside to eat the bread, but they cannot go out. Guruji remembers, once I used to spend my afternoon sitting on a tree called the Shiva tree. I sang at the top of my voice, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Finally, the branch where I was perched broke and I found myself on the ground. Every day I found a 5-rupee coin in the schoolyard. I hid it in my savings behind the lintel of the door in the cracks of the wall. I perched these coins so well in the wall that the money is still there. Still in 1984, when Guruji was 6 years old, he remembers, as I did not have enough money to buy images of Hindu deities, I used to collect all the images of deities that I could find in the newspaper or the calendars. If I ever had a little money, then I bought a picture of a Hindu deity. Sometimes after purchasing a picture of a Hindu deity like Shiva, Vishnu or Durga, my auntie would take it for herself because she did not have this one in her collection on her altar. At school, a girl whose parents had a shop brought some calendars that her father had given her to distribute to all the children. Every year, the shop gave out a calendar. So when that girl distributed the calendars, she gave me one with Vishnu on it. I said to her that I did not want this one. I knew that my auntie would probably take it away from me. And I asked her, give me this Muslim saint instead, pointing at the calendar that had a picture of Shirdi Sai Baba on it. That was how Shirdi Baba came into my life. I started to pray to him very often, and until now, I have very much reverence for him. My mom and auntie would tell me, what is this Muslim doing in our house? Put him out. I kept it and I insisted that he remains on the wall of my room there. I had a small altar when I was a child. It was hidden behind a big bouquet of plastic flowers high on the wall so that no one could see it. I had to climb on my bed to look at the deities behind and pray to them. But when my mom saw it, how eager I was to pray, she told me to put it down and keep the picture on a proper altar in my room. I installed it down on the floor next to my bed in a small corner. I used to sit and pray and sing in front of it together with my sister and the children from the neighborhood. Guruji continues and says, I spend the greater part of my time with my gods, but I love playing outside as well, like all children. We sang, we danced in the yard, or we played hide and seek, or cops and robbers. I loved also watching cartoons on TV with friends, but at our place there was no TV, no telephone. When my cousin Ravi came to live near us, we spent our days climbing trees, picking fruits, and we had a good time together. Jai Gurudev.